Hi guys and girls. Hey, making fossils with kids today. I want to show you my process, okay? I get these roasting pans and I fill them up to, you know, maybe one third of the way with Miracle-Gro. It doesn't have to be anything like that, but I like a nice porous soil as a bed. So I fill them up like this. Kids are going to come in. But then that's not enough to make fossils. You cannot articulate a good fossil because that's way too textured, right? Not dense enough to be a good fossil bed. So to solve that problem, I went outside and got looking around because it rained today, and I mixed me up a batch of real mud. When I say real mud, I mean, I'm talking mud. So this is the sort of pudding mud, and I mixed it with just enough water and made it a... Now that would be too wet, right? I mean, you couldn't make fossils in that, but that moisture is going to be drawn off by that bed that I put underneath this. Hold on a second. I'll let you watch my little processor. Will this be a mess to clean up? Oh, yeah. Will I be here late? Oh, yeah. Will the kids have a howling good time? Oh, yeah. So they've already researched their dinosaurs, looked at the skeletons of their dinosaurs, made stencils that they can lay right into this mud and start to press in, the indentation of the skeletons they've chosen. And then when they're done, I'll let these dry. And once they dry real well, I'm going to mix up concrete, actually sacrete, right? The bagged concrete that you use in your house and garden. And I'll mix colorant with it so it's not dull gray. And I'll pour it over these. And I'll let that cure. And once that cures, we're going to bury it all upside down so that the kids are actually digging through this mud and this soil, you know, as the soil on top of their hypothetical fossils. So that'll happen in spring. So I'll bury these things, and in spring, when the kids have good and forgot that they ever did this lesson, they will get to be archaeologists and, you know, grid off their area and start digging with their toothbrushes and their tools and dig down to their... Now, the other thing I'm going to do is label each one of these with their names. And so I'll keep track of where they're buried so that the kids can actually dig right where their fossils are going to be. So there's a little bit of planning involved in all of that, but it will be fun. So anyway, you get the gist, right? So creamy, chocolatey, messy dinosaur fossils. See ya.